Nikola Tesla is not only celebrated in the US or in Canada, Nikola Tesla, his name is known throughout the entire world. He's in the neighborhood of 300 patents in his lifetime. Those patents cover over 26 countries. It starts with the induction motor. That invention in itself is probably one of the most important inventions when it comes to power generation. That induction motor used electromagnetism, and that really is the start of power generation. George Westinghouse recognized that Nikola Tesla was a brilliant inventor. He reached out to Tesla, he bought the patents from him, then worked with Tesla, had him work within his company to further develop the AC system. Westinghouse, Tesla, they together designed this hydroelectric facility on the American side. Now you step back to 1892, where William Birch Rankin created a company in 1901 to 1905. The same company, although renamed Canadian Niagara Power, they then tackle creating the same plant with some improvements. They put that all into the plant behind me today. This particular facility has, that we know of, 9 patents from Tesla that have to do with the AC generator. There's 3 patents on the transformers, polyphase transformers. And then there's an additional group of patents that were related to power generation, power distribution. He is an incredible inventor. Through an attraction like the Niagara Parks Power Station, where we can celebrate Nikola Tesla's patents, we can celebrate the coming together of Tesla and the company of Westinghouse and the creation of the equipment. Children will be inspired, everybody will be inspired to hopefully become the next Tesla.
Nikola Tesla changed the world with his inventions, and many have come together across this country to tell his story. When Tesla was a child, he dreamed of harnessing the power of Niagara Falls. And in 2003, remarkable individuals in Niagara Falls came together to proclaim the first ever Nikola Tesla Day there. The community of Niagara Falls have worked hard in commemorating him, building a monument in his honor, landscaping the park in which it is placed, and renaming it to Nikola Tesla Plaza. A major road in Hamilton was renamed to Nikola Tesla Boulevard, and it is seen by the many drivers that take the QEW every day. And in Edmonton in 2019, Nikola Tesla Day was proclaimed. Here at Queen's Park on June 3rd, royal assent was given to the Nikola Tesla Day Act, and now across the entire province of Ontario, every July 10th is now proclaimed and celebrated as Nikola Tesla Day.
On October 18th, 1960, at the 11th General Conference for Weights and Measures, the Tesla unit was announced. It measures magnetic field B. It's called Tesla with a symbol T. A magnetic field is a vector field representing the influence of a magnetic material or a moving electric charge at all points of space around it. Two vector fields are referred to as magnetic fields: H, the magnetic field strength, measured in amps per meter, and B, the magnetic flux density, or magnetic induction, measured in Tesla. The Tesla unit was implemented into the International System of Units. This is a measurement system that includes units such as meters, kilograms, seconds, volts, newtons, amps, and so many more. The Tesla unit can be expressed in terms of other units as shown. Some typical examples of magnetic fields that we are familiar with include fridge magnets on the order of 1 millitesla, the magnetic field at the Earth's surface on the order of 20,000 to 60,000 nanotesla, magnetic resonance imaging, MRI, from 1.5 to 3 tesla. World records for magnetic field include 14.5 tesla, the highest magnetic field for an accelerator magnet at the Fermi National Accelerator Laboratory in 2020. 100 tesla, the highest sustained pulsed magnetic field at Los Alamos National Laboratory in 2012. 1200 tesla, the highest magnetic field lasting around 100 microseconds at the University of Tokyo in 2018. Nikola Tesla is honored for his fundamental scientific work by this international unit. In the words from the conference in 1960, the Tesla unit is for all times and for all nations.
Tesla's inventions, which are more than 100 years old, continue to be relevant and recognizable to this day, attracting the attention of many scientists and researchers. Another invention created by Tesla in 1914 as a means of resolving his financial struggles was a fountain. Tesla patented a fountain based on an entirely new principle. In addition, it has imposing effects despite the use of very simple apparatus and a small volume of water. A shaft runs vertically through the central column of the fountain, carrying a propeller at its lower end and an electric motor at its upper end, both sufficiently braced. Tesla was a great friend of Louis Comfort Tiffany, who was an American artist and designer who worked in the decorative arts and is best known for his work in stained glass. Tesla had a business agreement with Tiffany and prepared fountains which could be used in interiors. Tesla's fountain was unveiled outside the Nikola Tesla Museum in 2007, marking the 115th anniversary of the city officially plumbing and sewage company, the Belgrade Waterworks. It was made after the original project of Nikola Tesla patented in 1914 using a pump which uses very little electricity. It took 25 years for researchers to fully understand Tesla's idea and create a fountain like this.
Visible airwaves crackle with life. Bright antennae bristle with the energy. That evocative verse was written by Canadian songwriter Neil Peart. It nicely captures the idea of the unseen realm of electricity. Even the name of the song is wonderful, The Spirit of Radio.
Now broadcasting from Radio NTHSA, we bring you Tesla's claim to radio fame.
I really like the style of radios from the early 1900s, such as in this painting and in this lovely book of retro radios by Mike Tauber. They revolutionized mass communication, and Tesla was one of the first pioneers with his two radio patents in March and May of 1900. It didn't end there, though, because Marconi challenged them 6 months later, thus launching their 43-year patent war. Although Marconi's patent was rejected, wealthy investors, including Tesla's old rival Edison, got the decision reversed in 1904, and Tesla's patents were dismissed. The last chance to reclaim his invention was in 1916, when he and Edison again faced off in a corporate patent infringement lawsuit that took another 19 years for a ruling in Tesla's favor, and an astonishing 12 more years by the Supreme Court to finally reinstate Tesla's original patents in 1943, 6 months after he died.
In March 1895, Nikola Tesla's New York laboratory burnt to the ground. It was started in the basement of the building, but it destroyed his complete lab and all his equipment. So basically, he was starting over for a tremendous amount of work. He was close to demonstrating wireless transmission of radio signals from that equipment, but the fire stopped it. And then he carried on, and he was interested in the premise of high voltage electricity and wireless power communication. So he was searching a place to do that, and he was offered facilities in Colorado Springs with free access to power by a friend of his, Leonard Curtis, a lawyer, and he offered him land and a facility with power from the El Paso Power Company. Tesla had convinced John Jacob Astor and other investors to finance him for some of his experiments, and he used that money to set up the high voltage circuits in Colorado Springs. This famous picture of Tesla sitting in the center of the 50-foot diameter primary coil of his magnifying transmitter was actually a double exposure. So they too dangerous to sit there while the lightning sparks were discharging. So the photographer did one setup with Tesla sitting there and then did a second picture showing the sparks. But it is a famous picture of the activity. And look, this all had to be brought to Colorado Springs and built and set up in such a short period of time, from May of 1899 to January of 1900.
Nikola Tesla is mostly known for his contribution to the electrical world. In this Tesla tale, I'm about to illustrate his contribution to mechanical engineering and more specifically to car technology. As early as 1898, he patented electrical ignition for cars with gas engines. This is still current technology in use worldwide. In 1918, he patented the world's first speedometer. This speedometer was marketed by Waltham Company and installed in most of the cars at the time, including the Packard car, which was on the market until the mid-1950s. The speedometer was an air friction instrument measuring speed, total mileage, as well as the trip mileage, much like modern speedometers do today. Two words convey our feelings for his contributions to mechanical engineering and motoring. Thank you, Nikola Tesla, and we salute you on your 165th birthday.
Nikola Tesla's dream of harnessing the power of Niagara Falls became one of his greatest and best-known achievements. 9 of Tesla's patents were used in the power-generating stations that were built in the 1890s and early 1900s in the Niagara Falls and vicinity. The first was the Edward Dean Adams Power Plant, Niagara Falls, New York, that sent power to Buffalo in 1896. Next came the Q1 power-generating station in St. Catharines, Ontario, sent power to Hamilton in 1898. The William Birch Rankin Power Station was built in Niagara Falls, Ontario in 1905, sending power mainly to the United States. The Ontario Power Company, Niagara Falls, Ontario, was put into production in 1905. The Toronto Power Generating Station, Niagara Falls, Ontario, was in 1906, sending power to Toronto. John Patterson, a member of the Five Johns, wanted to send power to Hamilton from the Kew Power Generating Station, but was that possible? So they consulted Nikola Tesla, who confirmed that it was possible to send power over that great distance. 123 years later, this power generating station, the Q1, is still producing power. It is known as the cradle of the Canadian hydroelectric industry. This station, as can be seen in these pictures, is still functioning today and will function for years to come. The William Birch Power Generating Station has been renamed the Niagara Parks Power Station. It is a decommissioned station that is now open to the public. Walk through history and see how power was generated in the early 1900s using Tesla's patents.
When most people think of Nikola Tesla, this is usually what first comes to mind. Alternating current. The backbone that lights up our modern world. Though this may be the case, Tesla had many other innovations as well. Some 300 patents to his name, including advances in the field of medicine. Every radiologist is aware of Nikola Tesla's research in the field of electromagnetism. However, only a few radiologists associate the discovery of X-rays with his name. Tesla's experiments with shadow graphs and his observations of the biologic effect of X-rays are not well known, even among radiologists. Tesla reported that, driven by his observations of mysterious damage to photographic plates in his laboratory, he began his investigation of X-rays, which, at the time, were still unknown and unnamed in 1894. Apart from experiments using the Crookes tube, he invented his own vacuum tube, which was a special unipolar X-ray bulb. The bulb was a variant of his incandescent electric light. 1894, February 6th, U.S. Patent 514170. It seems that he produced the first X-ray image in the United States when he attempted to obtain an image of Mark Twain with the vacuum tube. Surprisingly, instead of showing Twain, the resulting image showed the screw for adjusting the camera lens. In fact, Tesla sent his images to Wilhelm Conrad Röntgen shortly after Röntgen published his discovery on November 8, 1895. Although Tesla gave Röntgen full credit for the finding, Röntgen congratulated Tesla on his sophisticated images, wondering how he had achieved such impressive results. Tesla is said to have made his discoveries a few weeks before Röntgen. However, we may never know the truth, as Tesla soon suffered a major setback. The main reason why Tesla's contribution to the discovery of X-rays hasn't become better known is that much of his work was lost when his laboratory in New York burned down on March 13, 1895. And yes, that is a picture of my Tesla coil that I built when I was 14. Tesla has been an inspiration all my life, and I still have a remnant from the times when he inspired me at a young age. Happy 165th birthday, Nikola Tesla, if you could only see what your inventions have done for this world.
This is a demonstration of Tesla's experiment of wireless transmission of energy using a Tesla coil. That is one of the greatest Tesla's inventions, and as he himself said, as revolutionary as gunpowder was to warfare. A small Tesla coil is built in a glass globe filled with a mixture of noble gases. Those are gases which chemically do not interact with each other. The coil produces high voltage and high frequency current, which excites noble gases. They emit thus absorbed energy in the form of light. Each gas emits light of color characteristic for its atomic structure. So, red is emitted by neon, blue by xenon, lilac by argon, and yellow by helium. That energy is wirelessly transmitted from the globe to a fluorescent light bulb, which is filled with krypton, another noble gas, which by the same principle emits white light, very similar to the daylight.
Before Tesla, the world of electricity was ruled by direct current, because for 100 years, the only source of electricity was from batteries. Thomas Edison was famous for inventing the phonograph. He went on to develop the incandescent light bulb. At the time, the electricity business was happy with direct current. Edison was a businessman first, so his street lighting system ran on direct current. Edison believed that all appliances should run on direct current, including electric motors. However, DC motors used commutators, which caused sparking that could burn out the motor. While still a student, Tesla thought of how to develop a much better electric motor. However, it ran on alternating current, not direct current. The DC electric motor uses a stationary magnetic field, which interacts with a DC electric current in a rotating coil. Tesla's AC motor uses a rotating magnetic field, which drags a rotor with it, forcing the rotor to rotate. There is no need for a commutator, eliminating the problem of sparking. This slide shows the position of the rotor and the rotating magnetic field. Edison was unimpressed. He believed that DC current was here to stay. However, George Westinghouse believed in the transmission of electrical power using alternating current. He realized that if we can place an electric motor at the end of an electrical transmission line, we can build factories anywhere. However, we need a motor that will run on AC. Tesla's motor fit the bill. And here it is, the original Tesla AC motor. Today, Tesla's motor is found everywhere from electric toothbrushes to the automobile which bears his name. Great things have small beginnings.
Nikola Tesla was born at midnight of July 10, 1856, in the small village Smiljan in current-day Croatia. It was a stormy night. Lightnings crisscrossed the dark sky and surrounding mountains trembled and echoed mighty thunder. The midwife said, "This will be a child of darkness." But Nikola's mother retorted, "No, he will be the child of light." That sounds as a prophecy because Tesla became a man who lit the world. He was a very intelligent and inquisitive child who inherited his mother's extraordinary memory and technical ability. Nikola had a very happy childhood at Smiljan. When he turned 7, his family moved to a city of Gospic. He felt like a stranger in that new environment and did not socialize with local boys. That changed when the city purchased a water pump for the firefighters. The plan was to start a mock fire and demonstrate to the citizens how the pump can move water from the local river and direct it onto flames. It was a festive occasion, and everyone was anxious to see that miracle. Alas, when firefighters started pumping, no water came out of the hose. No matter what they attempted, the pump did not work. Then Nikola asked whether he could help. They agreed reluctantly, but did not hope that such a little boy could remedy the problem. Then Nikola stepped into the river and inspected the hose. He found out that it was kinked as well as blocked by the debris from the river. He cleaned and straightened the hose, and water surged through it. Everyone cheered. Men carried Nico on their shoulders and treated him like a real hero, most popular boy in the city.